When we're in the parking lot of Chili's, everybody's gonna see me.
Today is a good day. No, not just because I'm uploading a video. Y'all are too sweet. Because UPS actually delivered my parts.
I love the guy that drops off my parts every day. Him and I are homies. I'd invite him to Thanksgiving if I knew him better. Got a couple things we're gonna be installing today. I've got a nice fun surprise that you guys already know. It's a, you know, it's a new trunk. And then I've got a little something special for Diode Dynamics in here. Sorry, it's like super bright. Hello, you guys see the sun? The sun is right there in my eyeball. Right now, what I've been doing to kind of counter my time waiting for this, I took off the valve covers, sanded them, prepped them, and now we're gonna be painting them for the R33. So, got everything plugged up, taped off, or started on round one of the crinkle paint. I love this, and I think I'm obsessed with it now. So, it's gonna look good, I already know it, but that's what's happening. And the next time I work on the R33, I'm gonna go ahead and remove as much of this as possible. There's a whole Italian restaurant up in here, dude. Nuts. Oh yeah, don't use that one, dude. This one should be good. There we go, cool. This crinkle stuff is super cool, but it's very picky. You have to wait like 2 hours between layers. As of right now, it just looks like paint drying, but it's gonna end up crinkling and looking super cool. First things first, I've been waiting for this for weeks. I'm so excited to see this box. Well, I mean, what's inside the box? I wish Victoria was here to help me film, but I'm just gonna do this solo today. This is a super light box, probably because it's carbon fiber.
Oh, that's light! Wow.
First thing you always gotta do is peep the fiber. Oof. Yes, sir. Now, I like all sorts of different types of wings on the 35. I don't mind the stock wing. It looks fine. But I'll tell you, I prefer aftermarket. I looked into getting the APR, but I kind of wanted to see what having the no wing feel would look like. And I know a lot of people love the Duckbill, and the style really works on the R35. So let's, okay, I'm gonna stop talking now. Oh God, dude. That is awesome. They had it packaged super well. Thank you guys. That's super awesome. And there she is. This package was sent to me by Vcrez. Vcrez is cool. They make a lot of really good carbon fiber pieces, aftermarket carbon fiber pieces for cars. And they also make durable body kits for drift cars. So they have stuff for like the 350Z. They even have stuff for like McLarens, Corvettes, a lot of stuff. So just check them out. I'll leave a link for you guys in the description. But this is going to look so good. Say goodbye to the, oh yeah, I forgot the wing was sparkly. I won't have this stupid sparkly wing no more. It's gonna be so awesome. One more thing though, I was sent something by our friends over at Diode Dynamics. This is going to be so cool. This is a turn signal relay for the R35. It's pretty simple, but it's really cool. Hey, thanks for the lanyard. I like stickers. Nicely packaged. So basically what this is going to do, it's going to turn my tail lights into my turn signals. And then my old turn signals, I'm going to replace the bulbs on those, and those are going to be my two reverse lights. It's gonna be really cool. We're gonna do both since they both have to do with the butt end of the car. I might have to even use these for when the reverse lights come on. I'm pretty excited. This is kind of like the intro to getting the build going. Obviously, we did a lot of power mods in the very beginning, but here in the next couple weeks, my whole car will start to come together. Pretty simple. I'm gonna need to take off all of these and transfer them to the bottom because I want it to be OEM plus. This actually should be a pretty simple install. Four bolts, a lot of little clips, and then deep in here, need to remove some paneling right here, and that'll take me probably 5 minutes to install. Usually, things go really well, and installs are easy, but when you have my luck, you have to drill out the things because they're seized and there's no other way to get them out, so. Not too bad, guys. We're done. This is the new wing, right here. It's pretty cool. Just saved a lot of weight.
Wow, this is light.
So at this point, I need to make sure it fits correctly. So I'm gonna eyeball it, move it back and forth, whatever I need to do. It looks like, now I don't have the latch or anything on it yet, but when it latches, Looks like it could move a little bit further this way. So I'm gonna lift it back up, I'm gonna push it up, and then tighten it all the way down. But damn. It looks so good, man. I'm just saying, this car's gonna have a lot of carbon fiber on it when it's done. Cause we like that. So in the midst of messing with all the trunk stuff, I already had a lot of the other stuff out. And here, right now, what I'm showing you is the difference between the stock blinker, which is this one right here, and then the aftermarket one. This literally was the simplest plug and play thing that I've done. Now I do have to change out a couple bulbs because it does make both, like I said earlier, makes both of these reverse lights. Whereas this one usually is your only reverse light. I need to now change this one out, but it's really cool. It uses the Godzilla eyeballs for the turn signals instead of this ugly amber. So that is super exciting and pretty cool. All right, it's a little later at night and I've done some adjustments. It looks a little better, but I'm gonna have to have Jose come and figure this out. I want him, since he's a professional, to go ahead. And it's not far off. I just need the latch moved far enough down to where that little itty bitty gap can be filled. Dude, this is gonna be so sick. It mounted up nicely. Honestly, I'm pretty impressed with the quality. Usually with fiberglass FRP type stuff, you usually have to do a lot of adjustment, but no, it ended up actually working out pretty well. I'm gonna go ahead and pop the trunk for you. I ended up just drilling the holes to make most of these little T-clamps, whatever you call them, fit. So it ended up making it sort of an OEM plus kind of look. And then you got the nice little carbon. It fits nicely, it closes nicely, and it looks really good. This look is gonna have to grow on me a bit because obviously I've owned the car for like 3 months now and I'm used to the wing. But I think, oh yeah. Every time I see a GTR with no wing, with some wheels, I think it looks pretty good. So anyways, let's go ahead and proceed on to the taillight mod. All right, Johnny, what do you think about it?
Makes it a little more subtle. Honestly, a bunch of guys have GTRs, but you're like, oh, hey, look, that guy's done a little something. He might know a little bit of something.
That's kind of true. I've thought about the same thing, and I'm like,
how many guys just come up and just swipe their car to get this car?
Yeah.
It's just like, hey, you know, you're actually building.
Actually modifying it.
Yeah.
Now that I come back outside, I'm looking at this now. I'm digging it. Okay, so now we're gonna be, I got a reverse light on. Oh wait, are you in, did you put it in reverse?
Yeah, I popped in
reverse. Oh, so we're doing the diode dynamics deal right now, and it's pretty simple, but Johnny decided to come over because he loves me.
Yeah.
So they gave me their own little set of diode dynamics stuff. They have, they're pretty all-inclusive. The diode dynamics is a lot of stuff. I've actually been to their factory before. It's a really cool place, and all of it's right here, so. Ooh, that's, look at them.
You see, look at that, how much one, nicer that was that the is? Little cheesy one they had.
Little dinky blue one from Amazon.
It came from the car, with the car, so.
Oh my God. Everybody is gonna know I'm backing up. That's, and then there's gonna be another one right there.
There's another one there and there.
Hell yeah. Nobody is ever gonna have the excuse of saying, oh, I didn't know you were backing up, dude. Dude, hold on, look at it on the camera. You can't even.
It looks like some headlights.
That's crazy. That is awesome. All right, now we gotta get this one hooked up. Look at that ugly, ugly amber yellow. We're about to have this eye-burning white LED. This is crazy though. I've never, like, these are some serious quality LEDs because I have not seen anything quite this bright. Uh-oh, here comes the ta-da. Dude, as soon as it hits that housing, it's like a ray from God coming down. Dude.
Oh my gosh.
Unreal. Everybody's gonna know I'm backing up now. There's gonna be no excuse.
Good.
When we're in the parking lot of Chili's,
I mean, look,
everybody's gonna see me.
All the way up to your door.
That is insane, dude. Turn the lights on for me so I can just see, like.
Yeah, I'm fit.
Even still. That's crazy. Okay, so now.
So his blinker was here, where this reverse light is now.
Okay.
And now the parking lights are now the blinkers.
That's cool.
I'm gonna turn the ISO down a little bit. That looks so sick. Okay, so yeah, now obviously the reverse lights are not always on, but. Now, that's how, oh, that looks so sick. That looks so much better. Look at my sweet little license plate bulb, too.
I was gonna say, beep, beep, beep.
Strobe. I'll get you some.
Okay. Thanks, Diodynamics. That is a really cool mod. If you guys, again, if you guys want to check this little mod out, I have the link for you in the description, as well as the VCres Duckbill.
Oh. Okay. Okay.
Corn. To give her one last look for tonight. It's like, it's for how light it is, it's so solid.
Right? Like, it doesn't rattle at all.
Yes. Oh, dude. That's pretty mad. Nice little overhaul in the rear today.
So, Fat Daddy right here?
Yeah, Fat Daddy. Twerk it Miley right there. Thanks to VCres for sending this out. Thanks to Diodynamics for the taillight mod. It's super cool. Again, I'll link both of the things we did today in the description of this video. And also big thanks to Johnny. He's actually just leaving, but super sick. I didn't actually need his help for this stuff because it was super easy and it came with instructions, but you know, it's always fun to have a homie over. Next, we gotta do some like carbon fiber roof, carbon fiber hood, carbon fiber tires. Look at this, bro. I'm gonna lock the car. Wait, unlock. My daily advice for you guys is I want to encourage you guys not to ever rely on worldly things for your happiness. Happiness will never surround you. Happiness will never envelop you if you focus on cars, women, money, jobs, relationships, that sort of thing. If you only pursue those things, you're never going to be happy. A good first step into happiness is just learning to be happy with what you have right here and right now and being grateful for the fact that you woke up this morning, the fact that you have eyes and ears and a mouth, a nose, hands, feet. And it's a lot, it's a very hard thing to practice, but I promise you it pays off. Love you guys. I'll catch you guys later. Y'all are awesome. Just want you to know that. Deuce. I have two videos in front of your dome. What I want you to do is watch those instead of clicking out. Don't X out. I mean, I don't care. If you're late to school or something like that, I don't care. You're still going to watch the video, okay? I'm going to go ahead and blow dry the paint, okay? Bye. Bye, guys.